Himalayan Village is near Kasol. We are around 6 kilometers short of Kasol and 10 kilometers short of Manikaran. This is in Parvati Valley, which is part of district Kullu. This is one valley from where one of the most beautiful treks in Himachal originated. This place was conceptualized by me in 96. On 9th of May 2000, I started with Sanjaju. In 98, I started the construction of this place, and last 98, and 2000, we got operational. And the time I came up with this restaurant here, or you know, this property here, Kasol was an unknown destination. Nobody knew Kasol. Challenge was to get a tourist here, but I was very clear in my mind that the property we come up with has to be open. I think when you come to Himachal, when you come to Himalayas, you need to be next to nature. Coming from a city like Delhi, Bombay, so it's pointless landing up in another city like Manali, Shimla, Dharamshala. They're as good as cities. So the idea was to be offbeat, be next to the nature. Because personally, if I go to a holiday in hills, I mean, that's what I look for. To be next to the nature, next to the forest, by the riverside. You know? And the idea was to showcase the culture of Himachal. You know, a person who's from Delhi, Bombay, he's already seen the best of 5-star and 7-star. So the idea was to come up with the traditional architecture, which blends with the profile of the hills. This is made in Katkunia architecture, which is the local architecture of Kullu. This architecture was followed, 50-60 years back and beyond that. Sadly, now people love coming up with, concrete structures, which are easier done and done in a much shorter time. So the idea was to recreate that architecture here. Katkunia architecture, to tell you, it's dry stacking of stone and wood. This is dry stacking of stone and wood. So the wood kind of acts as a beam to the structure, which kind of binds the structure. Inside, if you see these walls, these are all mud and cow dung plaster. So it's a typical village what we created here. We never call ourselves a resort. We say it's a village. It's a village. Shimla cottage, Manti cottage, Kinnaur, Lahore, Spiti, Kullu. And each cottage, the interiors, the decor inside, the paintings you have, the artifacts you have are typical to that district of Himachal. Chans are like tree houses. All the old temples, Devta ke jo bhandar hain, they are made in this style. That's what we've done. We've kind of come up with, used that architecture here. Amazing concept. Somebody staying at 50-60 feet of the ground. The entire structure is kind of hanging. They're entirely wooden. Like the other old buildings, our cottages are stone, mud, and wood. Machans are, the top of the machan where a person stays, it's 100% wood. It's entirely made of wood. These Katkunia architecture are very energy efficient. These structures are 7 to 8 degrees warmer in winter outside, and in summers it's 7 to 8 degrees cooler inside. They are dressed up in this local traditional Kullu attire. Our caps signify a lot of things. All our management staff are with these white caps, which are the Madana caps, and all our guarding staff and all, they wear the green Kinnauri cap. Service staff, they are all in typical Kullu cap, and even on our cuisines. You get all the traditional cuisines here. You get dham, you have sirtus, you have patrodus, you have patuji, all the traditional dishes. To showcase Himachal architecturally, culturally, evenings we have bonfires around that. We have our traditional folk dances, which is called Nati. At the moment, once which are operational, are two machans and 7 cottages. One would be added up probably in a month's time. We're coming up with 8 more double bedroom units, exclusivity and the old world charm of this place. Now, we have multi restaurants. We have 3 restaurants with different concepts. We have a bar, we have a spa where you can do a lot of therapies. Massages, jacuzzi, heat saunas, whirlpools, that we have this energy healing, partial irrigation, a lot of therapies to take care of your soul and the body. And then we have our adventure area where you can do a lot of perma bridges. But then we have a games area where you have billiards, table tennis, and all host of other games to keep you busy. Besides that, We are right next to Parvati River, which is famous for trout fishing. Trout angling is one of the major sports here. Besides, we have a lot of adventure activities like paragliding, rafting, river crossing, grappling, rock climbing. You can go for your nature trails, you have day treks, and besides that, yes, a lot of sightseeing as Parvati does it. But even for sightseeing, our idea of sightseeing is not to take people to the regular places, you know, where you have 5,000 people, 10,000 people already moving in. We explore new places and we take our guests there, you know. As far as awards and recognitions, they have certificate excellence from TripAdvisor for the last 7 years in a row. We are Traveler Choice Award winners from last 3 years in a row. We are the winners for even Holiday IQ Travelers Award. We've been covered by quite a few magazines like Alcove, Outlook, Exotica. We've been covered by Travel Trends Channel, who've done a special episode on our property. We made sure we maintained a 5-on-5 ranking right from day one, and which obviously comes from customer satisfaction. I have around 80% Indians and 20% foreigners, and the foreign segment is fast growing because we've been extensively covered in a lot of other foreign countries as well. We've been written about and people come to know about this property. Of late, we've had a Hollywood movie by the name of Ashram, which has been shot here and which will be shortly released. Our place has been frequented by quite a few celebrities. The Queen of Bhutan was here last year. In fact, they booked the whole place for 15 days. We've had Roop Kumar Rathore, we've had Lucky Ali, a lot of celebrities. I mean, I can tell you a few of them because there are a lot of celebrities who come here and don't want their name to be disclosed even while they're staying here or even after they leave. So there are quite a few of them which I'll not be able to mention. The Himalayan Village is near Kasol. We are around 6 km short of Kasol and 10 km short of Manikar. This is in Parvati Valley, which is part of District Kullu. We are around 22 km from the Kullu Manali Airport and 30 km from the main Kullu town and around 65 km from Manali.